Ladies and gentlemen, Anna Sale.
So, my grandma and her sister married brothers. Grandma, Artie May, married Tommy Temple after they met the World War story. And my Aunt Ann married Uncle Bailey after he came back from the war. And these brothers and sisters lived across a cow pasture from one another in North Carolina. And my grandpa and Uncle Bailey farmed together, just like their daddy has and their daddy before them. And they both had a boy and a girl. So the expectation was the boys would go on to be farmers and the girls would go on to marry farmers and continue to work the land. But June Sale, my mom, June's in the time, out of the plants. She goes to college. She lands in Nashville, Tennessee, college in the 1970s. Dates a singer-songwriter who gives tours of Johnny Cash's home on the side. And then he cheats on her. And she has a little farm girl remorse and ends up with a stable and secure guy, my dad, Bill. Moved to the suburbs. And this farm girl's remorse continues. She's guilty. So at least once a year, she piles me and my sister in the minivan. We go the 8 hours down to North Carolina to the farm. And for any like normal kid, a farm is awesome. You know, because you get to go to the hog pen and sell baby hogs. You get to ride the tractor with grandpa and sometimes steer in the cab. You get to touch the like wires that are electrified to keep the cows in the place. But I was a total brat. And I'm completely bored every time we go. Because I'm like, wow, everything is the same. Like all the cousins, all the people, wherever you go, the same. All do the same thing every time. And the food, no matter what the event, is exactly the same. It's a birthday party, it's a funeral, it's a wedding, it's Sunday dinner after church. You're gonna have ham, you're gonna have collard greens, you're gonna have corn. You're gonna have the same food that the same people bring. Because Cousin Mary, my mom's cousin, brings the deviled eggs, Cousin Arlene brings the cornbread, and Ann brings the pound cake, and Grandma brings the cheese ball. The cheese ball, in the South, it's cream cheese, cheddar cheese, it's pimentos for colors, in a ball. And so, you know, I fancy myself a trim maker, so I was not having this kind of monotony. You know, I show up at 8, got my nails spiked with my noose, it's 11, I'm wearing a jean jacket with pins and patches, you know, teen, my flannel shirts, Nirvana, and beers. Grandma's like, go with your cousins at 4-H meeting, talk about livestock fairs. I'm like, that's not what happened. So the grandma tries, and without fail, there's some community event every time we're down, she's having a cheese ball or four or ten. So grandma called me into the kitchen. She just showed me how it's done. You know, she'd get out the little rectangle cream cheese, then the bowl, then out the bag of shredded cheddar cheese, and she'd start folding it in. You gotta get to work, take your rings off, and just start kneading it to get the mixture of pimento in. And she just form it into like an exact spherical ball. And put it on the plate, and I'm like, hey, grandma's like, oh, it's good, it's good. So she even has to make cheese balls for her 50th wedding anniversary party. So she makes four. By this time, I'm 16 years old, and this is the party that's held in the Ruritan Club building. This is a cinder block building. This is kind of a farmer's club. And my grandpa and Uncle Bailey started it years before. And on the walls, it's Grandpa Uncle Bailey, Grandpa Uncle Bailey. They switched off from president by So I look around, and it's like all the same cousins, all the same people. They're always there. I'm sitting in the back of my sister. We're like, oh, Dave Matthews concert this weekend. So I remember looking up at the table. Back corner, and Uncle Bailey is there standing. And he's in front of the same spread of food and in front of the desserts and all the little pieces of pound cake or slices of little individual pieces of plates. I remember seeing him just sort of, you know, first like when he grabs the table, I'm just kind of watching. And then I see his like kind of knees buckle, and then he collapses. And I just hear a shriek, and then I hear, Bill, get Bill! It's my dad, the doctor. And silent, and dad's all of a sudden there pounding on his chest. And just one, two, and seconds later, my mom is just curled over her Uncle Bailey giving a mouth to mouth. And I'm standing in the corner, which is, I just want to be too. And then I sort of look back and I see my grandpa, my late brother, sitting in this folding chair, feet from Uncle Bailey. And then I see that his wife is sitting beside my grandpa, feet, just watching us. And then I sort of look back and I realize his kids are here, his grandkids are here, we are all here watching this. And this young woman, and it just, like, that's all that was happening, pounding around his chest, my mom doing mouth to mouth. And Michael Bailey's feet were just still. You could see his shoes and his brown socks coming out from under his legs. And they didn't move until the ambulance came. And so 3 days later, we're all gathered, the same people, and this time in the church reception hall after the funeral. And again, it's all the same people, and it's all the same food. I'm even wearing the same outfit because I just brought one outfit for the weekend. And I just realized that when everything stays the same, you see the holes that much clearer. And you see what's precious much clearer. And so I was thinking about this spring because I was back in North Carolina for my grandma's funeral. And sure enough, when I arrived at her house, her countertops were already full with ham and collard greens and corn. And the food kept coming with the funeral and after the funeral. And so by the time I've been there a couple days, the refrigerator is just stacked top to bottom with food. And it's the night before I have to go back to New York, and I'm just checking things out, looking for something to eat, and I look in the cheese drawer. And Grandma had about a dozen rectangular packages of cream cheese, and about 10 bags of cheddar cheese, and jars of pimento, just ready for the next event. And so I got out the cream cheese and got out the cheddar cheese and got pimento and getting more food. And I just put the cream cheese in the bowl and started folding in the cheddar cheese. And I took off my rings and started eating it. And then I just put the pimentos in and started making a ball. Pull off the plate. And I took it into the dining room and the whole family, the ones who were from the farm and not from